Hi, I am Anjana Sharma from Telcoma Technologies, and today let's have a look at NFB, which is a network function virtualization. So network function virtualization is an emerging technology and that can be used in our 5th generation. So what happens in this that we have a network operators, and those network operators are populated with large hardware appliances. So network operators, and these operators are populated with large hardware appliances. That means they require a large hardware equipment for the number of users so that they can meet their growing demands. Now, in order to launch the new services, that means this operator requires to launch new services. So, in order to launch new services, we require another variety. So, we require variety. So, variety of what? Hardware. And also, we require to have space. So, we require variety. We require space for that hardware that we use or we require to add on in our network. So, variety is space. And also, we require power to accommodate. So, variety, space, and power. Why? To accommodate these boxes. So, I can relate the boxes with the hardware that I require variety of hardware, I require space, and I require power to accommodate these boxes, which is becoming very much difficult. So, this process is becoming very difficult. So why this process is becoming very difficult? Because in this we require large hardware appliances because we have a huge demand from the users. So we require to launch new services as we are growing. So for that we require variety of hardware, we require space to accommodate, we require power. So in short, which is becoming a very difficult process, because by this we have increased cost of energy. So why it becomes difficult? Because we have increased cost of energy. We have investments. We require skills to design. Increased cost of energy, we have investments, we have skills to design, we have operation. Of complex hardware designs. So these are the problems that we have: more energy cost, we have more or investment cost, we require skills to design, we have complex operation hardware designs. Now, NFB aims to address these problems. So why we require NFB? Because network function virtualization has an aim to address these problems by using IT virtualization technology. So aim. So what could be the aim of network function virtualization? That it will remove problems. So how it could? how NFP aims to remove problems that we have discussed in this. So it will remove problems by using IT virtualization. Technology. So we are aiming to use IT virtualization technology to consolidate many hardware equipment types. IT virtualization technology to consolidate hardware types. So how it will consolidate various hardware types like servers, switches. We have various server, switches, and then storage. Now we are going to consolidate various servers, various switches, and storage, which are located in data centers. So these things are located in data centers. That means, with the help of NFV, network function virtualization, which aims to make my network very much simpler. So I want to use IT virtualization techniques in my network. That means I will consolidate various servers, switches, and storage which are there in the data center and apply the virtualization techniques in this so that my network architecture will be simpler and faster. Now, what are the benefits of NFV? So, the very first benefit is that this NFV will going to reduce equipment cost and consumption. So it will reduce equipment cost and consumption, which we require. As we require, my system, my network should be cost efficient. So with the help of network function virtualization, we are going to reduce the equipment cost and making the system more very much simpler. Now we have increase, that means increased speed. We will have increased speed of time to market. Increase speed of time to market by minimizing. How to increase time to market? Because we are focusing on minimizing operator cycle of innovation. So by minimizing operator cycle of innovation. So time to market will increase. Now we can use operator can share resources. Various operators can share resources . So sharing of resources, that means we are utilizing my resources more effectively. And then we have lower risk. So we are focusing on risk, and this is totally a new innovation in networks. So totally new innovation. So I can say that these are my benefits with the help of network function virtualization. The more is that we are going to reduce the complexity, we are going to reduce the cost, and we are making our system more effective, and time to market will have increased speed. Now we have various challenges to implement this. But before, let's have a look at how it could be achieved, or what is our aim towards this in network. Like, we have used equipment. And then we have BSS part, or we can say that RAN part. And after that we have a core network. Core network. With core network, we have storage also in the form of clouds nowadays, or we have any NMS system. Now, each and every system has its own manager. If I can give an example, so BSS or RAN part has its own manager like this. Core network also requires its own manager. And like NMS or clouds also has its own manager. So as per the number of entities in a network, I have the number of managers. Now what, with the help of network function virtualization, we can combine every manager into a single unit. So function of each and every manager into a single unit. The communication between ends could be maintained with the help of a protocol, and that protocol is open flow protocol. And this protocol will make communication between each manager possible. So this is aim. That means why we require network function virtualization, because we are going to reduce the number of network managers in a system, and we are clubbing into a one unit who will manage each and every entity in the network. Now, with the help of this, I have a reduced complexity, which is my benefit. I have a reduced cost, which is again benefit. Time to market will increase, speed. So these are the aim or the concept of network function virtualization, which we require in our system nowadays. Irrespective of different managers, we are combining together, we are making our system more effectively. So this is the concept of network function virtualization. Now let's have the technology challenges. So, technology challenges, the very first one is we require to reuse of BSS and OSS part. Base station subsystem and operation station subsystem, we require reuse of this part. After that, NFV will scale only if functions are automated. That means NFV will scale only if functions are automated. That means we require my functions to be automated in my system. After that, we have security from attack. That means these are my technology challenges which are required in our system. So I require my system to be fully protected. So that's why we require security in our system. So we have security from attacks concept, and also we require security from misconfigurations. So we require to take concern of the attack, we require to take concern of the misconfigurations, or we require to check software failures. as if any case we have a software failure, so that will software failure will disturb the system, so we require to have a check on the software failures. Now operators, this is the requirement of operators, which could be a challenge, that operator needs to able to mix So what they require to mix? They require to mix and match hardware from different vendors and hypervisors. To mix and match hardware from different vendors and hypervisors. So this could be the technology challenges that we require to reuse of OSS, BSS. We require only if the functions are automated. We require security from attacks. We require security from configurations. We require misconfigurations. We require software failures check. After that, operators need to mix and match because they are going to have hardware from different vendors and hypervisors, because we require to make our system simpler, so they require mix and match with hardware vendors as well as various hypervisors in the network. So these are my technology challenges. Now, as we have discussed, like I will compare that. This is a traditional approach. Now, in traditional approach, we have entities in the network, like we have BSS or we have a core network. We have a unit here, mobile station. So it is having its own manager, or I can say who can do the management of BSS part and manager of core network. Also, we have a storage, like I can say, like clouds. We are integrating with clouds, so we have a storage of clouds, and we require manager for this. Now, NFV aims, as we have discussed, that it is combining together. But we have some challenges because we are integrating various parts together. So we require proper flow of protocols between two ends. Now we have network function virtualization types also. In one type, each and every entity is communicating because they have open flow. In another type, we have open flow between two entities only, between the clouds and between the core network. And these are managed separately. So these are the management techniques that how we are going to manage our network with the help of network function virtualization, which itself a concept from IT techniques. So IT virtualization, because we require to have to save energy, we require to save cost. So that is why NFV is required in our system. So in this, we have a general introduction of NFV. For more lectures of NFV technology, please visit our website. telcomatraining.com. And you can subscribe on YouTube channel of Telcoma and also the Facebook page. So thank you so much.